200 grams plain noodles, 2 cup chopped cabbage, 3 tablespoon cooking oil, 1/2 cup sliced onion, 1/2 cup sliced green capsicum, 1/4 cup thinly sliced carrot, 1 tablespoon chili sauce, 1/4 teaspoon black pepper powder, 2 tablespoon vinegar, 3 tablespoon soya sauce, salt according to taste. So let's start with boiling the noodles. For this, take a big pan full of water and let it get a boil. Once water gets a boil, add noodles and boil them till they start becoming little soft. Be careful not to overboil them as we want them slightly uncooked. I have boiled them for 7 to 8 minutes. Now noodles are boiled, so strain all hot water and run noodles through cold water like this. Or you can just transfer them to a big container in cold water and let them cool for 2 to 3 minutes. You can use any method to cool down noodles. This helps in removing extra starch so they won't be sticky. Now transfer all noodles in a plate and spread 1 tablespoon oil on top. Now mix oil well with noodles. This helps in making them non-sticky. Now heat cooking oil in a wok at high heat. Check if oil is hot enough by dropping an onion piece. Oil is ready now, so add onions, capsicum, carrot and saute them well. Cook them for 4 to 5 minutes on high heat by continuously stirring till they are half cooked. We want all vegetables to be half cooked to give them little crunchy taste. After 4-5 minutes, add cabbage and cook it for another minute till cabbage is also cooked. Now put the heat to medium and add boiled noodles. Soya sauce. Vinegar. Chili sauce, salt, black pepper powder and mix them well for 3 to 4 minutes. If you find mixing noodles hard, you can take a spoon or fork and mix noodles with ladle like this till all sauces and spices are mixed well. Or you can use noodle ladle, which makes it much easier to mix. When mixed well, switch off the heat and our veg hakka noodles are ready to serve. Further garnish hakka noodles with spring onions green and julienne carrots to give it a restaurant style look. These noodles are so delicious and perfectly cooked. This dish is perfect as a starter if you are throwing a party or a potluck. Take some extra sauce or ketchup to add extra taste. Try this recipe and enjoy!